Rasuli Webster can bring Carter down. I may have to leave at halftime.
Well, they threw right over the blitz because they were coming hard like this, and then they just slipped Carter out right under him. See, here comes the blitz. Here comes Moretti and Mitchell, and then there goes Carter.
Well, they certainly know of the capacity of Oregon to put the pressure on using the blitz. They know that Nick Aliotta, the defensive coordinator, loves to send people. So they're dealing now on knowledge of the people involved and the philosophy of playing the game. And they're both profiting from it. First quarter is over.
In the first quarter, combined for both teams, 39 plays, 390.
Oregon leads Stanford 21-14, 35 points scored in the first quarter. No turnovers. Now, Oregon does have 14 interceptions, 6 fumble recoveries. They do make big plays, but their problem is they give up almost 300 yards a game passing, and that's where Stanford has been able to take advantage of them so far.
Stanford ball first down on the Oregon 33-yard line. Posada gives it to Carter. Carter's hit behind the line of scrimmage, but he's a big, strong guy, and he's going to get something out of it. David Moretti was the first man to get to him. Put the ball on the 31-yard line to pick up 2, second down and 8 coming up.
During that quarter change, I guarantee you, the defensive coaches were telling this defense, be patient, just keep getting after it. This is a team that will get sloppy with the ball. You've got to be opportunistic.
21-14, Oregon leading. Oregon might have been offside. Fasani pulls it down, and he's drilled at the line of scrimmage. Gets across the 30, but you've got an Oregon offside, I'm pretty sure. Darrell Wright looked like he got caught in the neutral zone.
Offside, defense, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Ball is on the 26-yard line now, where it is second down and 4 after the 5-yard penalty. Ducks have a 5-man front right now. Ball is given to Allen, bouncing outside, and Mallard couldn't do it. Mallard could not get to him and get a hand on him, and he's going to have another Stanford first down. And an Oregon man is shaken up and down on the field. So you've got a timeout for the injured player.
Watch this, Keith. Here's your guy, Pierce. Watch him come down on the linebacker like this. Watch these guys come on, and they're just kind of slanting off and cutting off that corner. Look at that. Just shielded off. And then there he goes, following all those white jerseys. It's just like sealing off the corner and letting him go around the end, and that's exactly why that play was so successful.
Stanford Cardinal knocking on the door again. It's first down and 10. The ball is just short of the 15-yard line on the Oregon side of the field. Right, the injured man walked off himself, just shaken up. Fasani gives the ball to Carter. Carter runs into some traffic at the 15-yard line. Quinn Dorsey back into the ball game, replacing Wright, and Dorsey led the defensive surge. Now here comes Luke Powell, number 6, into the ball game for Stanford, and Ryan Wells, number 4, both wideouts and both very fast.
Teo Johnson comes back in as well. This is a team, Keith, that's been very efficient in the red zone. 13 touchdowns, 18 trips coming into this ball game.
I think you would want Teo Johnson every time you got inside the 20.
Without a doubt. Without a doubt. And it's good to see him come in here in this situation, second and long.
Second down and 9 from the 14.
There he is, right there.
Pressure coming. Fasani got away from it and took a pretty good wallop down around the 10-yard line. I mean, he took a lick from Zach Prater. Big old tackle.
Not a bad decision on his part, though, Keith, to run that football. He was looking for Teo Johnson. We circled him. We showed you where he was. All right, now he just runs a quick out, and he's working on the safety, Webster. But he's covered. It's good coverage by Webster. That's when Fasani makes the decision right then. I'm running. He yells, fire, fire. Now everybody's got to fire on a block. Right here, he'll yell, fire. Now everybody's got to find a block. He tucks it away. Good decision on his part. Makes positive yardage in a play that wasn't there.
Zach Frater, number 54, who was involved in the play, is still down on the field. So here's Chris Lewis in at quarterback now, the sophomore out of Long Beach, out of Poly in Long Beach. Another one of those. Boy, they're everywhere. And it's third down and four. Tough spot for a cold quarterback. Lewis turns, gives to Carter. Carter in traffic, gang tackled. He's close to his first down. He had to get the ball to just about the five, and it looks like they marked him at about the six.
Keith, this is a statement game. Ordinarily, you'd go for a field goal here. I would not be surprised if they don't load up and go for it here on fourth.
Looks like it.
This is where you have one of the best offensive lines in the conference. You've got three seniors. This offensive line averages 303 pounds. You get in that huddle and you tell them, look, this is where you're best. Get us the yard and a half.
Rashad Bowman's got Teo Johnson. Top of the picture. They run it. And touchdown. Kerry Carter just slanted to the right side and scored for Stanford. It does not appear at this point that the Oregon defensive front can handle the Cardinals.
Well, they pull the guard to get him out in front. They seal the linebackers and Carter does the rest.
Viselli for the point. Good. It's the third time this game has been tied. We're now 21-21, 11:53 to play in the first half. We're in Eugene, Oregon, where the Oregon Ducks have won 23 in a row at home.
Even at 21 in Eugene, Autzen Stadium, but all eyes right now are on the Stanford bench. Randy Fasani has injured his right knee, and it looks like it's a knee sprain is what they're saying right now. Doubtful for the rest of the game, Keith, so we may see Keith Lewis the rest of the way.
All right, Todd, thank you. And Stanford tying the game at 21 will kick it off from the 35-yard line. The deep people for the Oregon Ducks. Ontario Smith, Sammy Parker. It's Parker, number one, coming from the goal line with it. He's a burner, but he can't find much room as the Cardinals track him down and stop him short of the 20-yard line.
Keith, we're talking about Fasani and the injury, and of course that puts a lot of pressure on young Chris Lewis, but keep in mind he's the guy that replaced Fasani in the first quarter against number five Texas and proceeded to throw for 214 yards and three touchdowns. And I'm sure everybody remembers what he did against USC when he came in and threw a game-winning 20-yard touchdown pass to McCollum. So, I mean, he's a guy that can come in and make some plays for you.
Comes off the bench very well, but I'm not entirely sure that he doesn't do better coming off the bench than he does starting. Look like they're going to put a cast on, temporary at least, on Fasani now, as Oregon will try to run the ball from around the 19-yard line and gets nothing out of it. The Aflac trivia question for this week. These six current NFL head coaches have coached at Stanford. How many combined Super Bowls have they won? That's a pretty good-looking list, isn't it?
Six. Boy, is it ever.
Ball is right on the 20. The gain was about a yard. Second down and nine. Morris, not a whole lot. He had a little crack there for a bit, but when he planted and got back to it, the white shirts got there. Yeah, but number one went up there and joined him. Yeah, ball had to be thrown in a hurry because there was
might be a fumble.
Apparently going to call it fumble. Brian Taylor picks it up and runs it into the end zone.
That's a touchdown.
And they're going to call it touchdown for Stanford. It was a lateral, maybe, huh? The ball ball was thrown out to Morris, and Morris didn't control it. Then went bounding around, and then Taylor picked it up and took it into the end zone.
There was a little indecision by the officials. They were all looking at each other for help.
And now they bring it back. Jim Springer suddenly comes over here and says, no, 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 and brings it back up. It wasn't. I don't see how it could. But he never had control of the ball. It couldn't be a fumble. It had to be a lateral.
If that ball is backwards, that's a live ball. And you know that the officials were a little bit confused, and they signaled touchdown. And then you're right. Springer came in and overruled him.
Well, he's right. He should. First punt of the ball game is coming up.
Incomplete. Fourth down.
That's a good bit of officiating right there, because they had already signaled. Although it's hard to tell from these angles, but right there it looks like that ball's being thrown backwards. That's a live ball.
Arroyo is in the punt. Luke Powell is waiting to return it for Stanford. Jose Arroyo has done a good job getting better as the season has gone along, and this time he can't get it to turn over. And it kicks out of bounds just barely across midfield. So that's not a very good kick. It's going to be marked out at the Stanford 48-yard line, 28-yard punt.
Keith, take another look. Let me look at this. You tell me what you think. Well, watch out where he throws it and where that ball is touched. All right? He's on this line. Go ahead and roll it now. That pass is backwards. That's a live ball. Should have been a touchdown.
I'm not sure.
Well, I'm positive
it's
now.
It's close. Because where was the ball thrown from? And marked it, but you didn't mark it back where the ball came from. Whatever. It doesn't matter.
Well, you're right.
The decision's made, and Stanford comes to the attack. The pass is completed down around the 45-yard line for a pickup of about 7 yards. Steve Smith working against Luke Powell. 45-yard line, second down and 3. Fumble. Stanford covers it. Casey Moore jumping on it. You've also got a penalty flag thrown at the line of scrimmage. Second down and 8. Chris Lewis gives it away to Brian Allen, and Allen whacked down a little bit short of the line of scrimmage. Rasuli Webster, who's played very well so far today with help from Kevin Mitchell.
Oregon loves to blitz on third and longs. See if it comes.
Third and 11. They've stopped it before the snap. Third down and 11 now. And Chris Lewis looking. Gets his pass away, and it's incomplete. Thrown behind Luke Powell. And it would have been an uncatchable ball under any circumstances. And Chris Lewis took a pretty good lick himself on that play. So as the day wears on, attrition beginning to set in as Fasani is gone with a big brace on his leg now.
Chris Lewis does not make a very good play here. They got pretty good pressure. They brought it off the edge. He felt it coming and then took a lick. Did not deliver a very good ball.
And here's Stanford's first punt of the day. That's Keenan Howery waiting. Circles under it. Gets a little room. Gets a roll. It's goodbye. Oh, the last man, Eric Johnson, brought him down. He had an angle, and he slipped past the would-be blocker, and he knocks Howery out of bounds down at the 6-yard line. 81 yards on the return. If Howery cuts it back inside, he walked in, but his tank might have been low. He might have been running on fumes at about that point.
Well, he reads this so well and gets so many blocks. Stop right here. Look at the block he gets here. Look at the block he has here and here, and the wall is set. That is just so well done by special teams. He's got the comeback blocker. Now it's just a foot race. Oh, that was so well done on the right return.
Outran Dorsey on the play. Couldn't get to him to put the block on him. But it's first and goal, Oregon, now at the Stanford 6-yard line. And this is Morris. And that's just about the line of scrimmage. Coy Wire, the tackle.
He's down in the running area, Keith, and Stanford's been very tough to run against.
Second down and goal from the six. Here goes Morris. Foot raise. He got there. Touchdown. And here's Siegel for the point. Good. And so Oregon goes back to the lead at 7:01 to play in the first half. We're expecting delivery of the triple digit scoreboard by the end of the third quarter. All right, we're at 28-21. Oregon back to the lead and a wild shootout at Autzen Stadium in Eugene. And the Ducks will kick it off now to the Stanford Cardinals. Stanford is without Randolph Fasani. He's hurt a knee and he's out for the rest of the day. Arroyo is going to do the kicking this time because Siegel hasn't put enough leg on it. And this time Jose gets more leg, but he hooks it out of bounds and it's up on the 35-yard line anyhow. Earlier we asked you the Aflac trivia question of which of these six current NFL coaches all coached to Stanford at one time as assistants. How many combined Super Bowl wins have they collected? Well, now the answer is four. Four Super Bowl titles. Dennis Green was the head coach at Stanford. All the others were assistant coaches.
Of course, Dick Vermeil and Coach Billick at Baltimore, they just won theirs the last couple years.
George Seifert was there with Bill Walsh. They just succeeded him. Long, colorful history. Stanford. First down and 10 now for the Cardinal from the 35-yard line. The Ducks have the lead. Now they'll try to stop Stanford as Chris Lewis goes back, gets his pass away, and throws it away. He was being harassed from the get-go as Darrell Wright, back into the ball game, kept reaching and reaching and finally got a piece of him just as he threw it. Now Texas has a 10-point lead over Colorado in the second quarter of play. And there, of course, is the one that made some noise in the West as Boise State beat Fresno State at Fresno last night.
There's Wright, grabbed the back of his helmet, pulled him forward. He still kept his balance. But Keith, you have the feeling that this drive is going to be huge psychologically for Chris Lewis.
Yep, I think so. Hands it away to Kerry Carter, and the Ducks now are getting some penetration and they're swarming. Kevin Mitchell, the first one to get there. Third down and 10. Blitz coming. Ball's away. It's not catchable. It's thrown into the seats. Number 39, Kevin Mitchell, blitzing, was in his face when the ball was released. And that was not a good series for the Cardinal. And they'll have to punt it.
For that guy right there, though, that's not all bad. Third down and 10, he ends up throwing it away. That could have been a very, very difficult situation for him. He throws a pick there, changes the whole ball game. He throws it away. He's okay.
Punter Eric Johnson is in there. He's had a punt blocked in each of the last two games, but he was the one who tracked down Keenan Howry a little while ago and kept him from scoring on a return. That's a low line drive kick. Howry goes back, fields it at the 20-yard line, and this time he doesn't quite get the same ball he had before. It's up on the 39-yard line. First down, Oregon. Ontario Smith is in there as a single back now for Oregon. Harrington back throwing. Got a man. Harry, penalty flag thrown where Harrington was put down. It could be holding. It could be roughing. Harrington rolling out. Got a good block. Got a pass away. Pass is completed up beyond the 40-yard line. Right at the 40-yard line to Sammy Parker. It is second down and 9 from the 40. Harrington gets his pass away, and it's complete to George Webster, the tight end, and he picks up a first down. Big George, 6'4", 245 from Van Nuys, California.
We just call this a little slipster. Just take that thing and just kind of slip right in there. And Harrington does this as well as anybody. Kind of holds the linebackers up with a half-hearted play action, and then there he is, just kind of folds in behind him. That's a big load. Now, I want you to watch number 15 here, Taylor. Just kind of dive at his feet and take him over. Say, he's bigger than I am. I'm not rapping. I'm just going to trip him up with my body.
And it's first down at midfield for Oregon. Little option action. Pitches it back to Ontario Smith. Transferred, went to Tennessee originally. Played there, didn't like it, came back to the West. And then came here, and he just bolted for a first down at the Stanford 26-yard line. And I think old Bo has just put on a green shirt.
2 inches shorter, 2 pounds heavier, and getting better all the time.
Here comes Howry. He's got it. Going to throw it. Comes back the other way, trying to throw it back to Harrington. Harrington got tangled up with one of the linebackers, Matt Fredericks, and couldn't get loose. And Matt says, aha, I see you trying to sneak out there, and he wouldn't let him. And the pass is incomplete.
There was no question they had contact. He impeded his progress. Here's the flip back. Reads the play nicely. Reads Keenan Howry, who leads him there with his eyes, and then he just jumps in front of him. Watch 51 right of your screen. That's Fredericks. Kind of hits him and says, wait a minute, I didn't do it. And the ball was overthrown. They said it wasn't catchable, but could have been called for defensive holding.
Hit second down and 10 for Oregon. This is becoming Keenan Howry day around here. This is Ontario Smith going over the right side. He hits in there with a pretty good suck. He's a 5'10", 195-pound sophomore. And he's inside the 25 to the 23. Third down and 7. Rolls this way. Howry's over here. He lets it go, and it's incomplete. Sammy Parker turned back inside. Howry was not available. He simply couldn't make progress down the field. They wouldn't let him. And Parker turned back inside, and by then the ball was gone. So hey, it's fourth down.
Keith, we were both talking about momentum. That is a pretty good stop for Stanford. They can go ahead and take that and build upon that.
They're going to go for the field goal here. Siegel will come in, and he's going to hit the ball from the 31-yard line. So it's a 41-yard field goal try for Oregon. He has the leg for that distance. It won't come back. It just misses to outside the right upright. And so Stanford holds, and Oregon is turned away. And it's 28-21, Oregon with 3:21 to play. And get up in the morning and have breakfast with his mom and dad. Ball is handed off to Brian Allen. Allen breaks a tackle, runs through the stack, and goes all the way up to the 40-yard line. Rasuli Webster finally dragged him down. It'll be the 41-yard line.
You watch him run, and you say, how does he get free? They had defenders all around him. You know, Ty Willingham was telling us this week. He said, Brian Allen is tough, he's intelligent, and he anticipates well. What he's added to the package is the ability to become more instinctive. And he just kind of feels a hole and slips through one, even if it's just barely there.
First down on the 41. Chris Lewis back looking. He wants to go deep. He's looking for Johnson. Can't find Johnson. Now you got a penalty flag thrown. The ball is completed up here at the 47-yard line of Oregon. But let's see about the flag.
Holding, defense. Declined. First down.
It's on the defense.
How about that? Oh, with Maryland and Florida State going after.
Ball's on the Oregon side again, 48-yard line. They run it with Brian Allen. Having a hard time getting him down. He's down to the 45, pickup of 2. Second down and 8. Chris Lewis. Play action, pass is thrown and completed to Casey Moore coming out of the backfield, and that's right on the first down marker and a yard past it, so move the chain.
Well, and you start running the ball, and then you go to play action, and then all of a sudden you start throwing to your fullback underneath, You're taking away the long pattern. Now, why is this successful? Well, look at this offensive line. You look at the games that they've started. You look at the experience that they have. They've got the three seniors. They average 303 pounds. This is what makes this running game go. This is why they're second in the conference in running the ball.
I think Chris Lewis might be a little better at the short passing game, too.
Yes.
The deep stuff. He's looking to go deep this time for Luke Powell, and that's looped up over his head and well beyond. Not catchable as Bowman defended on the play. Need the wind machine to come in here and pump everybody up at halftime. They've screamed themselves hoarse already. 28-21, Oregon leading.
35 first quarter points, I guess so.
Timeout, Stanford. That could be a problem. It's like Oregon's had what amounts to about three seasons so far.
And don't forget, UCLA has a makeup game after USC.
Arizona State.
The last time they had that, Miami bit them, took them right out of the national championship picture.
And all kind of potholes down the road. All right, here we go on second down and 10. Stanford ball at the Oregon 36. Oregon leading 28-21. Well, there's something going on at that end of the stadium, and whatever it is, they want it either moved or stopped. Well, there's an automobile driving around down there, and they want it out of the way. All right, it's out of the way. Going second and 10. Here we go. Got a man in motion. That's Carter. Chris Lewis back looking to throw. Goes down the middle with it. Throws it over the head. Yeah, I don't think Casey Moore ever really located the ball. He was looking over his right shoulder. The ball was thrown over his left.
There is a flag, and it's going to be holding against Stanford. So that incompletion even gets worse on all kinds of pressure.
Quinn Dorsey, I think, was the primary pursuer here.
Well, they overloaded on the left side. They brought pressure from everywhere. Got good pursuit. Dorsey gets the hit. And there's holding, just trying to keep him off the quarterback, Lewis. Belotti says decline it.
Well, that's a 10-yarder. Yeah, they're going to enforce it.
Well, I don't know why he would want to even try to decline it, because now it takes him out of field goal range, moves it all the way back to the 46, almost the 47. And it makes it second down in a taxi cab ride.
Ball is just short of the 46-yard line, second down and 20. Oregon defense trying to take away now the Stanford offense. And getting more penetration, the ball is thrown into an open space, and it is incomplete. Well, the Stanford defense fought him off a little while ago, and Siegel barely missed a 41-yard field goal. Score remaining at 28-21 with 2 minutes to play in the first half.
Your mismatch was at the top of the screen.
Lewis's pass is away, and it should, no. Bowman had an eye on it, but he couldn't get to it either, and now you got another penalty flag thrown back up here on the other side of
this
midfield.
Might be on Moretti for hitting
might
late.
Be. Might be. Carter. Ducks hit like they're a little hot right now, and Moretti was the man. Second down and 9. Chris Lewis rolls and looks. Throws underneath, and it's incomplete. He tried to get it to Luke Powell, and he's lucky to get it back. That was almost picked off. Crowd trying to help. Lewis gets it away. He's hit as he throws, and it is batted away, incomplete. Kevin Mitchell had a shot at it and just tipped it. Either he hit the arm or he hit the ball. Wind is not a factor. On the way, hooked it badly. And so Stanford is turned away. Sadi hurt a knee. He's in a brace, and he's out for the day. Maybe longer. This is Maurice Morris. Breaks that tackle. Goes to the 40-yard line. Close to a first down. Coy Wire. Quite a remarkable guy. He led the team in rushing at one time, moved to the defensive side of the ball, and now leads the team in tackles. Here's part of our conversation with him yesterday as we talked about him being dinged up a bit.
You know, the rest of our defense as well is going to have to step up, and, you know, it's the true measure of a man isn't where he stands in times of comfort, but when he's faced with adversity.